A construction company is taking at least some of the responsibility for that deadly collapse of the Hopple Street Ramp Bridge along Interstate 75 just last month. WLWT News 5's Tammy Mutasa live for us this evening with the results of the internal investigation. Tammy?
Curtis, the construction company sent us this statement saying an engineering mistake may have contributed to the Hopple Street Bridge collapse. Now today, Kokosing CEO Brian Burgett says that engineering mistake may have led to the bridge collapse and the subsequent death of construction worker Brandon Carl. The old Hopple Street Bridge on 75 was being prepared for demolition when it collapsed last month. Burgett says the demolition plan was flawed and didn't have key details instructing workers how to remove the ramp's concrete surface. Burgett says they have shared the preliminary results of the internal investigation with ODOT and OSHA. Kokosing has hired an outside engineering firm to help them with oversight on future demolition plans. Now, CEO Brian Burgett said, quote, "While nothing we do can change the events that happened on January 19th, we are taking this additional step to improve the safety of all our workers and everyone impacted by the construction work that we do." Now, I reached out to Carl's family, but they had no comment, and neither did his fiance. Reporting live, Tammy Mutasa, WLWT News 5.
All right, thanks a lot, Tammy. We can tell you that last week, Carl's family filed a civil lawsuit against the Ohio Department of Transportation for negligence and carelessness. The State of Ohio Court of Claims is handling that lawsuit.